let's talk about the third part of the DNA discussion, or the advanced DNA discussion about the DNA structure, chemical properties and their functions. Now let's talk about some unique features of DNA in this slide. Now let's talk about the sugar puckering and what is the importance of sugar puckering in DNA strand and in maintaining DNA strand. The sugar puckering is actually the sugar ring, what we all know is a very basic sugar, which is glucose, is made up with 6 carbons. So it's a 6 or hexagonal ring, but in case of sugar from the DNA, it is pentose sugar or 5 carbon sugar. The structure of this pentose sugar, we draw something like that, which is a simple form. But actually the conformation of the stereochemical conformation of the sugar can be drawn using Boat and Chair conformation. And you all know the Boat and Chair conformation, how the chair and boat conformation differ with each other. And what is the importance of that is that Boat or Chair conformation usually tells us, this is one structure. This is how the boat conformation looks like. Okay, so this boat conformation helps us to identify the presence of the steric consequences in a structure of a molecule or structure of a molecule like sugar. So unlike the 6 carbon ring of glucose, the 5 membrane ring are highly flexible in nature. So they are not actually usually stay in a planars like the 6 member rings. So they can be the some region of them, some carbon of them can be putting upward, slightly tilted upward from the plane. And some carbon positions or carbon moiety, different moieties attached with carbon can be pointed downwards regarding to the plane. So these things can be happening. The 5 atoms of pentose sugar are not coplanar. That's what I am telling you. They are not coplanar. So they are not in the same plane. We can see in our future slides, we will see that some of the moieties is pointing upward from the plane, some of the moieties pointing downward from the plane. So what are they doing? Why they are doing like that? Is to actually promote those different moieties. For example, as we know, in case of this sugar conditions, the C1 is responsible for making the N-glycosidic linkage with nitrogenous bases, and the three or the five carbon position responsible for making the phosphodiester linkage. So these are very, very important. These places are very, very important for the future studies. What we will see that these places are actually helping of establishing the backbone structure, or hold the backbone structure really close together. Okay, so when you are talking about puckering, the puckering actually helps to maintain this kind of structure. That means if some part of this carbon ring pointing upwards, though they are actually pointing upwards to align themselves close together towards the bases for the particular or good attachment of the bases with them. So that's how it's done. Now let's move on to the actual situation. Here is a picture to actually show you. So this is the situation. You look about this structure of pentose sugar is slightly like that. Now what happens in this picture we are looking at, this is the carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4, and the carbon 5 is here. So this is how the structure is related. So what happens in this picture is only this 3 carbon position, if you hold this 3 carbon position and you pull it upward, it will make a structure like that. It will make a structure like this. So what happens here in this case, all the rest of the sugar is one plane, what you're looking at in this plane, but one carbon position of it is slightly putting upward, which is the 3 carbon position. Okay, so this 3 carbon position is attached to the and the rest of the other carbon position just stays there. So this 3 carbon position will attach to the phosphate via the phosphate with the next sugar, which is pointed downwards like that. Okay, so that's the importance of this 3 carbon, as you all know. So what happens in this position, the 3 prime is facing the upward, we call it the 3 prime endo, C3 endo conformation. this conformation is not usually found in DNAs, okay, DNAs or RNAs and whatever you can say. In mostly in case of DNAs, this formation is not found. So what happens in this case, as we know, as a result of this 3 prime upward direction, this phosphate ring, this phosphate and this phosphate, the distance between the two phosphate is getting increased. So the distance So the distance between them is getting decreased. Normal situations, when this sugar is placed in one plane, what happens? There is a particular distance which is maintained by this phosphate. So this is one phosphate and this is another phosphate. A particular distance is maintained. But in this picture what we are looking at, as a result of this pulling out of this 3 prime, this phosphate is getting closer, so the distance is getting nearer or narrower, like 5.9 angstrom. But in the other case, when it plays in a normal situation, where in this second picture what we are looking at, the 3 prime is in the plane and the distance remains 7 angstrom, right, with respect to the two phosphate groups in the different points. But the other case is looking at, in this case, is the 2 prime position of the sugar. If I draw it schematically like that, then the 2 prime can virtually place here, but it is actually tilted upward. So you put the 2 prime and pull it upward, it will make a structure like that. And guess what? What will be the name of this structure? It will be the C2 prime endo conformation. And this is the most relevant conformation. This is the most abundant conformation that is found in DNAs. We call it the B conformation, not the beta, B conformation. This conformation can be found in case of B DNAs. So there are different types of DNAs depending upon the different structure of the bases, different structure of the alignment of base sugar and the interaction of this base sugar and phosphates together. So this kind of structural feature can be found in B DNA, and this kind of structural feature is found in A DNA. So now let's talk about the N-glycosidic torsional angle. So what do we mean by N-glycosidic bond torsional angles? Torsional angle is something which is presented due to the stress between some bulkier groups. So as we all know, if again I draw the structure, so remember one thing, whenever I am demonstrating something, I am using the help of structure, because if you know the structure of the DNA, every question can be answered really easily. That's the basic key for answering all these questions. So this is the point, here the base attaches like that, so I am drawing again schematically like that, okay. So what will be this torsional angle? The N-glycosidic bond torsional angle, that means the bond between the base and the sugar carbon 1 is that N-glycosidic linkage. So this linkage can have different torsional angles, different torsional bond, torsional stress due to the presence of this bases, because the bases are actually made up with bulkier rings. Some of the bases are made up with only one bulky ring, some of the bases are made up with more than one bulky ring, we call them the purines. So let's look at these torsional angles in this case. So what we have here, simple, the ribose sugar, this is the N-glycosidic linkage, and in this linkage we can see the huge bulky ring, which is a purine in this case, which is an adenine in this picture, as we know. This purine is placed here, and these are the two different orientation of how the purine can be attached or oriented with this sugar molecule. So in this case we are looking at a scene orientation where both the rings are presented just upward of the just on the top of this sugar ring. That again, from the normal concept or normal common sense, we can say this structure will not be favored because it will create much more torsional strain than this structure. This structure is a little bit of free because these two bulky ring is putting outward or facing outward portion, not the upper region of this sugar. So this structure will be favored because it is having the less torsional strain. So this orientation is called the anti-orientation of the N-glycosidic linkage. So this is favored in most of the bases, but in few bases only, in one base actually, it is a guanine. As you know, in guanine we can see the scene orientation is favored over the anti orientation in very, very specific conditions. If we look at this adenosine, adenosine, it is a scene orientation, it will not be favored. And in case of cytidine, it again not be favored because here is a double bonded oxygen, so it is not be favored. In case of guanosine, normally it is not favored, but in very very difficult conditions, we will see later, in case of some of the different conditions when the DNA has to be arranged in such a way, such a zigzag way, and not only zigzag way, but there are two different nucleotides attached with each other, two different sugar attached with each other via the opposite side linkage, like this dinucleotide sequences. In those situations, we can find in some cases guanine can exhibit the scene orientation more over the anti orientation. Okay, this is the only situation. We can look at this kind of situation in case of Z conformation of the DNA. We call it the Z DNA. And in Z DNA, sometimes the scene orientation of guanine can be favored over the anti orientation. But in other cases, all this type of scene orientation are forbidden. The uridine scene orientation will also be forbidden. The only anti-orientations are permitted because they process less torsional strain. Okay. Okay. In this picture, let me change the color. Yeah. In this picture, what we are looking at is these bonds. And this arrow suggests us that this bond can be rotated, as we all know, in scene orientation and in anti orientation. So this is not fixed. The N glycosidic linkage is not fixed in its own place. It can be rotated around to make a scene orientation and also the anti orientation. It depends on the situation when the DNA wants to put the structure of the bases in scene orientation or the anti orientation.